In explaining him about salvation, we came to a new subject. He said, how do you get saved? What will save you from going to hell? I said, well, that's what Christianity is best at. We have the perfect salvation. We have the grace. He said, how does it work? I said, well, the grace works like this. God can't forgive sins, so he sends his son to die for everybody's sin. He said, why can't God forgive sin? Well, I don't know how that works. He said, and if he can't forgive sin, then how come after he kills his son, he can forgive sins? I don't know how that works either. He said, and you're guilty, but his son is innocent. So where in history do we find it that it's good that innocent people have to be killed for the sake of the guilty ones? Well, I don't know how that works either. So we had a problem with that one. Especially when you consider if your child is bad, really bad, maybe he did something to the cat, maybe he threw stuff out of the refrigerator, ran around the house on a skateboard, broke the television set, broke some windows, maybe let the car roll out into the street and get hit by the trash truck. So you come home and you said, look what he did. But I can't forgive him. So I've got my other child over here that didn't do anything at all. So I'll beat him up. No, I'll kill him. The innocent one. People would put that man in the insane asylum, wouldn't they? They'll lock that man up for that, right? Society won't accept that, so why does religion accept it? And if you accept that, then it should be okay for people to kill their innocent children. But Islam forbid the killing of innocent children. They forbid it because some of the ignorant Arabs used to do that. Kill their innocent children, especially their daughters. Islam forbids killing of the innocent. Whoops. Well, I had to stop on that one. Let's back off of that. Well, forget about the Bible. Forget about the salvation. That doesn't work. He said, especially when you talk about salvation in Islam, we also say what you say. You say nobody is saved except by grace. That was everything we knew in Texas. I heard that so many preachers said, nobody is saved except by grace. He said the word for grace in Arabic is rahmah. And the Quran begins with rahmah. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Yes? How many times Allah says, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, throughout the Quran? Too many times. So many times Allah talks about rahmah. And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, talked about Allah's rahmah. So much rahmah. One of the hadiths he talks about that Allah has 100 parts of rahmah. And one part of the 100 was used for all of mankind and all of his dunya. One part. All the mercy you ever saw or ever imagined since the beginning to the end is one part of Allah's rahmah. The other 99 parts is waiting for the believers on the day of judgment. And the Prophet said, peace be upon him, nobody is saved except by this rahmah. They said, even you, Rasulullah. He said, even me. So who has the grace? Okay, let's get off of that subject. I'm thinking we'll move to something else.